Good afternoon to all. In the last class, we derived the complete derivation for how to convert a star network into a delta and vice versa. We also did two problems on star delta transformation. Now we are going to see a few more examples on star delta transformation technique while calculating the total resistance of the network. Okay. Now, so coming to the outcome of this today's lecture, at the end of this class, the students will be able to calculate the equivalent resistance of different networks using network reduction techniques. Okay, na? So these are all called network reduction techniques, like simplification of series resistors, parallel resistors, and star to delta transformation or delta to star transformation. Mean these techniques are used to reduce a complex network into a simple network. Simple network in order to calculate the equivalent resistance. Okay, so that we can able to calculate either current flowing through the network, voltage across different elements of the network. Okay, na? Now, this is the objective outcome of this today's class. Now, come to first problem. Find the equivalent resistance between the terminals A and B. This is a network given. There are different connections between the terminals A and B. Here, our task is to find the equivalent resistance between the terminals A and B. So while calculating the resistance between the terminals or resistance of the total network, first you need to observe or identify, is there any series and parallel combinations first, because they are easy to reduce the network. If you are unable to identify the series and parallel combinations, then you can check for either star or delta, okay, which is to be converted into other one. Okay, so therefore here in this problem, there is no series combination, there is no parallel combination at all. All are individual elements. Okay, so there is no series and parallel combinations. Okay, na? No two elements are in series or parallel. So then you can check for star or delta. So here there are two deltas in this network. Okay, this one, two deltas formed by 4.5, 7.5, and 3, and 4.5, 3, and 7.5. So if you convert these two deltas into star, so that you can get some simplified network, okay, which will be given in the next figure. To convert two deltas formed by 4.5, 7.5, and 3 ohms to equivalent star networks. So that it will become like this. So I will draw inside before going to this one. So if you see here, so this will be like this. So this is one corner. Okay. This is one. Here we called as this is R5 and R4. This is R6. Similarly, here also. So this is R1. This is R2. This is R2. So if you simplify, okay, after removing delta, the equivalent network will be like this. So here you need to calculate R1, R2, R3, and R4, R5, R6. So suppose for R1, what are the two side arms? 4.5 and 7.5. 4.5 and 7.5 by 4.5 plus 7.5 plus 3. Like that for R2, 3 into 7.5 by 3 plus 4.5 plus 7.5. For R3, 3 into 4.5 by 3 plus 4.5 plus 7.5. Okay, the product of two side arms by the sum of three arms. Sum of three arms. Okay, na? So see here, this R1 is equal to R6 because R1 is between 4.5 and 7.5. Here R6 also between 4.5 and 7.5. So therefore, 4.5 by 7.5, 4.5 into 7.5 by 4.5 plus 7.5 plus 3, which is equal to 2.25 ohm. 2.25 ohm. Okay, na? In the similar way, R2 is in between 3 and 7.5. Here also R5 is in between 3 and 7.5. So therefore, R2 is equal to R5 is equal to 3 into 7.5 by 4.5 plus 7.5 plus 3, which is equal to 1.5. Then R3 is equal to R4. R3 is equal to R4 is equal to 4.5 into 3 by 4.5 plus 7.5 plus 3, which is equal to 0.9 ohms. 0.9 ohms. Okay, na? Okay. See here, now after getting this network, you just again simplify this network. Okay. So here R3 plus 4 plus R4, these three are in series. Okay, na? These three are in series. So these three are in series. So what is R3 value? R3 is 0.9. So 0.9 plus 4 plus R4. R4 again 0.9. So which is equal to 5.8. 5.81. In the similar way, these three are in series. What is R2? R2 value is 1 ohm, 1 plus 3 plus. What is R5? R5 is 1.5. 1.5. 3, 4, 5.5 ohm. So these three are in series, leads to 5.8 ohm. Again, these three are in series.
So R2 is also 1.5 ohms, sir.
R2 is 1.5. Yeah. Yes. Fine. Good. R2 is 1.5. So that it gives the 6 ohm. Okay, now 6 ohm. Then you, so therefore, this equivalent network becomes, 1 ohm. This equivalent network becomes, so R1 parallel with, R1 is in parallel with these two, then this one. Okay, here it is R6, here it is R1, and here it is 5.8 ohm, it is 6 ohm. Okay, that will be given in the next step. Okay, na? I hope it's clear. Okay, so 5.8, 6 plus 2.25. Now in this network, these two are in parallel, then calculate parallel equivalent of these two. Okay, R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. So So 5.8 into 6 by 5.8 plus 6. 5.8 into 6 by 5.6. Okay. This is earlier. 5.8 and 6 ohm. Then parallel equivalent of this one. Okay. This one. For this one. Parallel equivalent of these two. Or 5.8 parallel with 6. Or 5.8 parallel with 6. 5.8 into 6 by 5.8 plus 6. Which gives the 2.9 ohm. 2.9 ohm. So this one. 2.9 ohm. So finally, these three are in series. 2.25, 2.95 and 2.25. All are in series. So then the series equivalent of this one is equal to 2.25 plus 2.95 plus 2.25, which is equal to 7.45 ohms. It is equal to 7.45 ohms. So this is the another problem. Find the equivalent resistance between terminals A and B. Terminals A and B. Okay, now? A and B. So here again, so after getting any problem, first you need to identify what are the elements which are in series and parallel. Series and parallel. Suppose, first you search for series and parallel combination. If you are unable to find series and parallel combinations, then go to star delta combinations. Okay, na? See here. Suppose, if you think these two are in series, but in between, there is a branch going. So therefore, here current is dividing into two parts. So current division means they are in parallel. Something in parallel. Some elements are in parallel. In a similar way, coming to the next node here. Suppose, if you think these two are in series, in between, again, there is a current division takes place. Okay, so therefore here there is no again series and parallel combination, no series and parallel combinations. So then, so you think about something. Okay, na? So therefore, you just redraw the network by taking these two points, Okay. So the network seems to be like this. Okay. So, however, here all resistors are 10 ohm, it seems to be somewhat confusion. Suppose if they are different, then it will be more easy to understand. Okay. See here, you take some C here and D here, point C and point D here. Here you take point C. You take point C here. Okay. And here. Point D here. Okay, now bring C and D in center, then from A to C 10 ohm and A to D 10 ohm, C to B 10 ohm and D to B again 10 ohm, Okay, so your resultant network becomes like this, So here again, it is very easy. We already solved some problems on this. So here there are two deltas, but there is one mutual element between these two deltas. So if you convert any one delta, so that you can easily calculate the resultant resistance. You convert any one of delta, however all the elements you think, you convert any one delta. Suppose if you think this is plain, you can convert this one or any one of this, no issue. Okay. I will tell you any one of these two. Okay, so he solved this one, then you calculate, you redraw from here. Okay, from here onwards you calculate. Okay, na? So this from three corners you come, you draw. these three. Okay, this is R1, R2, and R3. R1, R2, R3. What is for R1? For R1, 10 into 10 by 10 plus 10. However, all the resist three side arms are same, so you can directly calculate. Okay, one at all elements at a time. All elements at a time. Okay. So therefore, R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R3 is equal to, okay, 10 into 10 by 10 plus 10 plus 10. Okay, now 100 by 30, 10 by 3. This gives 10 by 3. Okay, now 10 by 3. Then the equivalent network may be like this. Okay, 10 by 3, 10 by 3, 10 by 3. So here these two are in series. 10 by 3 and 10 are in series. Then 10 by 3, 10 are in series. So you straight away calculate equivalent of these two. 10 by 3 plus 10. Okay, 40 by 3. Okay. Here 10 by 3 plus 10, 40 by 3. 40 by 3. Okay, I called it as equivalent 1, equivalent 1, 10 by 3 plus 10, 40 by 3, again 10 by 3 plus 10, 40 by 3. Okay, after this, the network may be like this. The network becomes like this. Okay, now 10 by 3 as usual, then 40 by 3, 40 by 3 came in parallel. Now these two are in parallel. You calculate parallel equivalent of these two. Parallel equivalent of these two. 40 by 3 into 40 by 3 by 40 by 3 plus 40 by 3. You will get 20 by 3. Half of that. 20 by 3. Okay. So then these 20 by 3 and 10 by 3 are in series. Are in series. Okay. You can straight away add these two. Straight away add these two. Okay, these two are in parallel, so you add those two so that you can get 20 by 3 plus 10 by 3, 30 by 3, 10 ohms. 30 by 3, you can get 10 ohms. Okay, now. Now consider the another problem here. He asked us to calculate the resistance between terminals A and B. Terminals A and B. A and B. So straight away, simply by seeing this network, so here we can straight away observe the two configurations here. One is delta between ABC, delta between ABC. Okay, and there is a store between ABC, star between ABC. Okay, now you convert either from star to delta or delta to star. Suppose if you convert outer delta to star, okay, this becomes again complicated solution. Complicated solution. So that's why, okay, to have simple solution, you convert the inner star into delta. Inner star into delta. The star network formed by 6 ohm, 3 ohm and 4 ohm, okay, should be converted into delta so that you will get three parallel arms, so you can easily calculate the resultant resistance. So you should expect almost next 3 to 4 steps while starting the first step. Okay, don't solve the problem blindly. Okay, now you expect next 2 to 3 steps. Okay, by keeping that in mind, you start the first step. Otherwise, okay, you will face some problems in the middle of the solution. So you have to start again. Okay, so unnecessary, you will waste your time. So that's why you think next 3 to 4 steps, then start the first step. Okay, now, so now you convert the inner star, the star formed by 6 ohm, 3 ohm, 4 ohm into delta, That resultant will be like this. Okay, resultant will be like this. I will draw that. Okay. See here. The star is converted into delta. Okay. Okay, this is R1, this is R2, and this is R3. So what is R1? For R1, okay, the formula is, okay, 6 into 3 plus 3 into 4 plus 4 into 6 by opposite element for R1. What is R opposite for R1? 3 ohm. Okay, that means 6 into 3 plus 3 into 4 plus 4 into 6 by 3 ohm. So what is R1? So for R1, R1 is equal to, okay, na? 6 into 4 plus 6 into 4 plus 6 into 3 plus 3 into 4 by for R1 opposite is 3 ohm. 3 ohm. Okay. Similarly, what is for R2? For R2, the numerator is same. Okay, na? Numerator is same. Okay. 3 into 4 plus 4 into 6. Plus 6 into 3 by for R2, what is opposite? 4. For R3, what is R3? For R3, numerator is same. 3 into 4 plus 4 into 6 plus 6 into 3 by 6. Okay, na? So that is given here. Formula substitution. For R1, so it is simplified version because here 3 gets cancelled. Okay, remaining 3 comes into here. Okay, na? Here if you suppose if you calculate simply for R1, what will get? For R1, 24 plus 18 plus 12, 30. Plus 54 by 3, which is equal to 18. So you must practice all these things along with me. Okay, na? Don't move by taking snaps. Okay. So therefore, R1 is equal to 24 plus 18 plus 12, 54 by 3, 18. So like that, you'll get R2, 13.5, and R3 is equal to 9 ohm. 9 ohm. Okay, the resultant network is like this. So now you can easily calculate. Now see here, these two are in parallel. R2 and 1.5 are in parallel, and R3 1.1 is in parallel, and R1 9 is in perfectly parallel. So you simply calculate parallel equivalent of this one, and this one. Okay, na? This is after substituting the values. Now you calculate parallel equivalent of these two, and these two. Now, suppose, as I said, say this is R1. Where is R1? This is R1. You call it equivalent of these two. You call it as R1. Okay, na? This one seems to be R1. Okay, and this seems to be R2, and it seems to be R3. So parallel equivalent of these two, R1 into R2 by R1 plus R2, 9 into 18 by 9 plus 18, 6 ohm, whereas 1.5 into 13.5 by 1.5 plus 13.5, 1.35, 1 into 9 by 1 plus 9, 9 by 10, 0.9. Okay, so this is the resultant equivalent network A, B, C as usual. But here he asked us to calculate the equivalent resistance between A and B. A and B. So you have to calculate the resistance between A and B. A and B. So for A and B, okay, na? So you think this is A and B. Okay, you are injecting current here. Suppose, for example, you are injecting current here. So that is dividing into two components. That is dividing into two components. This one and this one. Okay, it is coming to B like this. Whereas the second one going to 1.35. Okay, 1.25 and 0.9. The same current flowing through 0.9 also. This indicates these two are in series. These two are in series. So therefore, okay, the resistance between A and B, A and B is equal to six parallel with 1.35 and 0.9. 1.35 and 0.9. Okay, six parallel with series combination of these two. Series combination of these two what? 1.35 plus 0.9. This is equal to 6 parallel with 2.25. Okay. So 6 into 2.25. 6 into this is equal to 6 into 2.25 by 6 plus 2.25. This gives 1.64 ohm. So now consider the another example shown in figure. Again, he asked us to calculate resistance between A and B. Resistance between A and B. Okay, na? So in this figure, if you closely observe, there are some series connected resistors. There are some series connected resistors. Okay. So here, the 5 and 25 are in series. The 5 and 25 are in series. So these two are in series. These two are in series. Okay. These two are in series. Again, these two are in series. So you calculate equivalent of these two. So 5 plus 25. This gives 30 ohm, okay, here, and 10 plus 5, 15, 10 plus 5, which is equal to 15 ohm. That 15 comes to here. So after combining these two, the resultant network becomes like this. Okay, but after that, there is no series and parallel combination. But inside there is one delta. This 20, the delta is formed by 20, 15 and 5. That was drawn here. 20, 15 and 5. So you just convert this delta into star. Delta into star so that you can get like this. Okay. So this one. Maybe this may be R1, okay, and it may be R2, and it may be R3. So after removing delta, because we converted delta to star, so after removing delta, this network may be like this. 10 ohm is connected to R1, and R2 is connected to 30 ohm, and R3 is connected to 2 ohm. However, we removed this 15 and 20 and 5. So this network may be like this. Okay. So that was given here. Okay, now. Okay. 10. Now you calculate the equivalent of this one. R1 is equal to 20 into 5. 5 ohms. 20 into 5 by 20 plus 5 plus 15. 20 into 5 by 20 plus 5 plus 15. This gives 2.5 ohm. Okay, na? 100 by 40. Whereas R2, 20 into 15. 20 into 15 by 20 plus 15 plus 5. From 300 by 40. 2.5 plus 2.5, 7.5. Whereas this one, R3, 15 into 5, 15 into 5 by 6, 75 by 40, 75 by 40, 1.875. Then you substitute these three values here. R1 is 2.5, R2 is 7.5, and R3 is equal to 1.85. Okay, however, see here in this circuit, R2 and 30 are in series. R2 and 30 are in series. 10 and R1 are in series. R3 and 20 are in series. 20 are in series. Okay, na? So you substitute R1, R2, R3 and add so that you can get the next circuit. Next circuit. See, before adding the series combination, these two are in series. Okay, again, these two are in series. Okay, and these are also in series. 10, 2.5 here. Okay, na? Here. 10 plus 2.5 here. 10 plus 2.5, which is equal to 12.5. Here it is 30 plus 7.5, which is equal to 37.5. Here it is 2 plus 1.875. 2 plus 1.875. This gives 3.875. Okay, na? So after adding the series resistances, this gives 37.5. Okay, this gives 37.5. And it is 3.875, and here it is 12.5. Now here again, how can you solve it? So this seems to be the which or which what we solved in the previous problem. Okay, na? So two deltas. This is one delta, and this is another delta. But however, there is common element between two deltas, so that you can convert either of the delta, either this one or this one. Okay, na? So he converted his delta, the second, this side delta. So this seems to be like this. Okay, so here you convert. Delta sum R4, R5, and R6. R4, R5, R6. For R4, product of these two by sum of these three. For R4, 37.5 into 3.875. Okay, this gives sum 2.04. For R5, 30 into 3.875. 30 into 3.87. By denominator is same. 1.63. And for R5, R6, 37.5 into 30. 37.5 into 30. 15.76. Okay. So therefore, the equivalent will be like this. 12.5 is connected to R4 and 15 is connected to R5. And D is connected to R6. So that was we drawn like this. 12.5 R4. What is R4? What is R4? 2.04. Whereas R5, 1.63. Here it is 15.76. Now see here. These two are in series. Okay, na? These two are in series. That is 12.5 plus 2.04. This gives some 14.54. Again, these two are in series. Okay, na? what is 15 plus 1.63, 1.63, which gives 16.63. Okay, before going to solution, I will try to draw that. Okay, what is the resultant here? A. Okay, from A is dividing into two components. Wait. Okay, okay, then you can go next one. So that seems to be like this. Okay, so 12.5, 2.04 are in series, 15, 1.63 are in series. The resultant R equivalent 1, I call 14.54 and 16.63. Okay, now so this seems to be like this, 14.54 and 16.63. Again, both are in parallel. You calculate parallel equivalent of these two. So what is that? 14.54 into 16.63 by, okay, and here this is wrong. Okay, now okay, this is wrong. So here this one here some are equivalent. So here R equivalent is equal to what we will get. R equivalent is equal to 14.54, okay, into some 16.63 by 14.54 plus 16.63, which gives that 7.764. Okay, now these two are in series, so therefore the resultant 15.5676 plus 7.76 with the resultant is 23.52 ohms. Okay, now find the equivalent resistance between terminals A and B. Okay. So here, see, there is a network. You just identify first series and parallel combination. So there is no series and parallel combination. But somehow, if you closely observe this network, there are two stars. There are two star configurations. What are those two star configurations? 6, 4, and 8, 5, 3, and 4. 6, 4, 8, 5, 3, 4. These three are in one star. 6, 4, 8 are in another star. Okay, you convert these three. Suppose if you want to draw like this. Okay, I will draw with this with the two pens so that you can understand better. Okay, see here from 6 to 4, 6 and 4. Okay, 6 and 4. This is 6, 4, 8. Okay, so this is 6, 4, 8. This is one conversion. Coming to another conversion, 5, 4, 3. See, corners are same. Corners are same. See here, 5, 4, 3. So this is 5, and this is 1, and 5 and 4. And 3 and 4. So that you can get in the next step, these two are in parallel. Okay, na? So for that, next. So convert one by one. You first take inner star, 5, 3, 4. Then convert it into delta. Okay, na? As we drawn. You call it as R1, R2, R3. R1, R2, and R3. You calculate R1, R2, R3. What is R1? R1 is here. Product of each two. 5 into 4 plus 4 into 3 plus 3 into 5 by. For R1, opposite. What is opposite for R1? 3. R1 is 3. Okay. These are the formulas. Substitution for R1. Okay, 5 into 3 plus 3 into 4 plus 4 into 5 by 3. So here 3 gets cancelled, 5 into 4 by 3. You get 15.67 ohm. So like that you calculate remaining two also. Okay, na? This is one. Okay, na? So here it is. R1, R2, and it is R3. Suppose for R3, 5 into 4 plus 4 into 3 plus 3 into 5 by 4, 4 here. So this is the R3, you will get 11.75 ohm. Now come to outer star, 6, 4, 8, their values have not been changed. Okay, that is 6, 4, 8. For 6, 4, 8, again, this is the substitution. For R6, what is R6 here? R6 is the top element. The R6 is the top element. So for R6, 6 into 4, you can have 6 into 4 by 4 into 8 plus 8 into 6 by, for R6, opposite is 8 ohm. Opposite is 8 ohm. Okay. So therefore here, this is R4. For R6 by 8, so you'll get 13 ohm. For R5, 17.33. And for R4, 26 ohm. 26 ohm. So you substitute all of them there. Okay, as I told you already, three are in parallel. Parallel, the first network, we'll go back. See here. Okay, all are in parallel here. This one. See, but here this element remains same. It will not be changed. Okay, that is very important. Okay, earlier these are converted to delta. Inner stars are converted to delta, but however, this element is remain same in the circuit. That is appears in the resultant network. That will be appears in the resultant network. Okay. Here. That is the last one. The short circuit as it is. So now, as I told you already, these two are in parallel, these two are in parallel. But however, this short circuit is there. Because of this short circuit, okay, these two resistances are also short circuited. So the resultant resistance is equal to zero. Okay, na? Even if you apply parallel principle, you can get zero. Okay, na? Mathematically also you can get zero, because if you apply mathematical formula also, if suppose the resultant of the parallel equivalent of these two, there are three elements are in parallel. If you calculate these two elements are in parallel, okay, that is some R equivalent. Here this path resistance is zero. Short circuit means resistance is equal to zero. So finally, this total resistance RT for these three is equal to 0 into R equivalent by 0 plus R equivalent, which is equal to 0. But even if you technically speaking, if you release some electrons here, okay, instead of this resistance, where here it has zero resistance, so all the electrons flows through this short circuited path. So it will be open. So you can neglect this resistance. So therefore, here these two are in parallel. You calculate parallel equivalent of these two and parallel equivalent of these two. Okay. 11.75 into 13 by 11.75 plus 13, 6.17 ohm. Here 15.67 plus 26 into 26 by 15.67 plus 26. Resultant, you can get 9.78 ohms. Okay. So therefore, here these two will become parallel. Here it is 9.78. Here it is 6.17. So the resultant network will be like this: 9.78. Parallel with 6.17. So these two are in parallel. So therefore, the parallel equivalent resistance is equal to 6.17 into 9.78 by 6.17 plus 9.78 leads to 3.78. So therefore, the total resistance of the network.
Sir, why is randomness, sir?
Why? No, I'm from my end, no problem, Andy. You please check your end. Huh?